Hi, I'm Anthony Roth Costanzo, and Happy New Year. Are you ready for some New Year's Day magic? I know I certainly am, and I'm very excited to be your host for today's holiday presentation of Cinderella. I mean, what better way to ring in 2022 than with a fairy tale about the triumph of hope and love over adversity? Cinderella is the newest addition to the Met's popular series of family-friendly holiday shows. This English adaptation of Massenet's Cendrillon is true to the classic tale that everyone knows and loves. And this fanciful storybook production is the creation of French director Laurent Pelly, whose wonderfully wacky costumes are sure to bring a twinkle to your eye.
Hi, horsies.
A dream team of mezzo-sopranos leads our cast. Isabel Leonard stars as the rags-to-riches heroine, Emily D'Angelo is her Prince Charming, and Stephanie Blythe sinks her teeth into the role of Cinderella's over-the-top stepmother. And at the end of today's performance, don't go away, because immediately following curtain calls, I'll be backstage for live interviews with Cinderella and Prince Charming. But now, Maestro Emmanuel Villaume is ready to go to the pit. Here is Cinderella. And I'm off to the ball.
So nervous, I haven't come to criticize.
guys, I'm at your service. Come on now, when no one's seen. He scares me too. Go on. Madame is ringing.
Monsieur is very kind.
Go on. You'll be fine.
Oh, Madame. Ah, Madame.
For a month, why should I allow her to keep the household on the run? The time has come to set things right, to assert my power. Was once quiet and humble, far from the town, just me and my daughter. We didn't have very much, but we had each other. We had to leave that Pourquoi? Temptation knocked, and I responded. A countess came along. Mon Dieu, I married her. She had a way about her, so bold and energetic. I could not say no, no. She had two daughters, a pair of pampered brats. I made the choice, how I regret it. And now I'm suddenly responsible for everything they say they need. Those two are greedy as can be. Woe is me. My two stepdaughters live a life of ease and splendor. Meanwhile, my child must dress in rags and sleep in cinders. I see her suffering, my poor neglected daughter, never complaining or protesting. I hope she knows how hard I've tried to make things right. I hope she knows she's not alone.
Hello!
My wife! Let's go! Adieu, goodbye to hope!
We tonight there's a ball at the stage. not be higher. If we hope to advance, tonight could be our chance.
Advance, Mamma? What sort of chance do we have to advance, Mamma?
A chance of momentous importance.
But a chance for what? Why tonight?
A ball is being given by the King of France.
What a chance! Tonight to meet the King of France.
His son, the prince, you know, is single.
The prince, Mamma, I'm all a tingle.
If you would win the prince's hand, you must prepare yourselves for combat.
To arms, to arms. We shall do battle in the ball.
We shall do battle in the ball.
We shall do battle in the ball.
You mustn't flinch or give an inch to your opponent. Take big care with your toilet. Never let them see you sweat. You must arrive at the ball like a bombshell. Avoid the competition if you want a royal bow. It's a propos in love or war for you to decimate your foe. A bolt of lightning!
A bolt of lightning!
A brilliant bombshell. Elegance and grace, my petite. Give a little pout when you smile. Would nothing could be more exciting.
Pendant ma bouche!
Parfait! C'est magnifique! To dominate the ballroom, you mustn't be banal.
We are the most unique.
Tonight,
awesome.
Tonight.
formal.
Yes, you do look better than normal.
But the cut of that coat is passé.
You don't say.
Passé.
But still, it's for Brad, not for you.
You haven't said a thing about a roof of gold. A coat from the field.
Those dresses are to chic. It's always best to tell them what they want to hear and not attempt to interfere. Let them dismiss and detain me. I'll bide my time and hope and pray the world will see the truth someday. And lock her away, she's crazy.
Wake up, are you asleep? Always off in a world of your own.
Come along to the fray,
today,
come
on,
pay.
Today,
I'll pay.
Today,
my heart breaks for my daughter, my child. She suffers more than me. I must tend to let out while my child sleeps in ashes. No time, there's never time to kiss her goodnight, nor to tuck in her covers, nor to tell her I love her.
Yes, no.
With a beauty and with a breeze, that's a
breeze.
With a beauty and with a breeze, that's a
breeze.
With a beauty and with a breeze, that's a breeze.
Sisters get everything they want and more. Like brilliant butterflies, they sparkle and soar while I sit by my hearth alone in a little creaking.
night it will be, but not for me, not me. That's enough, that's enough. I should be glad for what I have. There is work to do, no time for dreaming. Finish your work, all will be
you sigh and you suffer. You think that no one sees a thing. But I will come.
Shimmer like a rainbow, rainbow. eyes. Open your eyes. Arise, open your eyes.
Thank you.
come and see the festive preparations underway. You won't believe it.
Won't believe it.
Though your bed is cozy and luxurious someday, you must leave it.
You must leave it.
So say something. Just a word, just a word. No.
No. He doesn't say a word.
No. No. The king declares that one and all shall have a good time at the ball.
Come McMary, noble prince. No.
As the noble poets.
No, the poets are a bore.
They say.
A bore. He's depressed. He's depressed. He's a mess.
Let him rest then.
arranged for the debuts of dozens of suitable beauties. Yes, tonight you shall choose. When you marry, dissecting your mood shall improve. No more delay, no more dispute. The king has walked and send them through.
Thank you. Oh, no, if only so, I, yes. This is the moment now or never to shop on. This is the day, your time for shop. I, yes. This is the moment, yes, the moment has arrived.
The moment, yes, the moment has arrived.
Soon the prince will descend.
On the bride, he'll descend on the bride.
Overcome with wonder.
Thank you.
The church was with the hymn of the dawn. Oh, 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 oh.
suffered so long. Come, come rest in the arms of your father. To see you in pain, Mother Jupiter. We should never have left our sweet house in the woods. I wanted you to have a rich and happy life. I failed you. Come. Tomorrow we must go.
And even Timbuktu.
on in Bombay and Gibraltar, in hope to join the prince here in France at the altar. But when my girls appear, how astonished they'll be. The mermaids will rise like the roar of the sea, and we three shall advance, and the people shall part, they shall part in a shall smile and extend his royal hand, and we three shall approach the ruler of the land. Voila! Voila! We stand, we stand before the king.
Thank you. This is Susie, dresser extraordinaire. She's amazing. We couldn't do the show without her.
Thank you.
I'm gonna let you go ahead.
Thanks. Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, Isabel, Emily,
Hi.
Bravo,
Hi.
That was amazing. Oh. You took us on such a romantic and a moving journey. How do you feel?
Good. So I mean, good. I have no, you know, after a show, you really aren't quite connected to your brain again, so it's going to take a minute for actual words.
Just floating. How about you?
Great. I feel great.
Great. We have one word answers for you. Sorry.
It was amazing. I was watching. It was so incredible.
Thank you.
Also, there are so many kids in the audience. Mm-hmm. What does it feel like to see those young faces looking back at you?
I think it's like an energy. My son's in the movie theater, so I love you. I know.
Yeah, it's amazing. There's nothing like an audience of kids, really.
They were loving it. And we actually have some questions from some of your newest young faces. Fans. So first, we're going to hear from 7-year-olds Levi and Zane.
Great.
Why did you choose to join the opera? Why did you want to be in the opera? Did you think it was a cool activity?
Oh,
so cute.
What? You go first.
Okay. I love music. I've always loved music and singing, and, you know, opera is just, it's everything. It's music in the pit, music on stage, it's art, it's costumes. Yeah, you get the best of every world.
And you're so musical.
Oh,
what about you?
I know, she almost made me cry. Well, she did, and I had to hold it back because I was still on stage. But it's just, it's all of the things that Emily just said. It's the beauty of telling a story collectively with everyone on stage and off stage and just being in another world for a little while. It's nice. It's
and
nice
I love
escape.
How you brought us on that whole journey with you. So we have two more from 12-year-olds Sage and 6-year-old Orly.
How do you not get hoarse after every opera?
How do you not lose your voice after every performance?
That's a good question.
Classic. A classic question.
I mean, we're not superhuman, even though we'd like to believe we are at times. I think because we have such demands as opera singers, if we had to sing shows every night, you know, every night, 5-8 nights a week, like you would on Broadway, I'm not sure I would be able to do that. So we try to take care of ourselves. And then sometimes you get sick.
It's true, but it's like an Olympic sport. You have to be in best form.
Yeah, you train for it. You know,
exactly.
It's like being an athlete. You just train and train. And
we don't just roll out of bed and do this. There's a,
some
there's
of our colleagues
of
can. I don't know how they do.
Yeah, I'm jealous of them.
But I can't. No.
There's lots of prep and warming up and all those things. Yeah. Well, yeah. Isabel, Emily, you and the rest of the company have made so many people happy on this special day. Thank you so much.
Laurent, would you tell us a little bit about your inspiration for these incredible costumes?
Yes, it's for me it's first a pleasure to invent this kind of costume, but the inspiration is the music first. And the music is an incredible combination between humor, emotion, and fairy tale. I work also with Barbara de Limbourg, the set designer, we work from the idea that the fairy tale is first a book. And I worked with a book from my family, from Charles Perrault, with a picture of Gustave Doré. And we decide to use only the three colors, the color of the first page, the red, and the color of the paper, and the dark
beautiful.
Of the letters. And it's why the all the production is only with this three colors and the page of the fairy tale.
A palette based on this original book.
Yeah.
Amazing. Well, tell us about the costumes that we have here.
These two costumes, they are of the daughter of the stepmother. It's also
very
funny.
Yeah, around the leg area. It must be a little interesting to walk in them, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. And it's very funny to invent a shape, something between ridiculous, they are stupid girls, very, very pretentious, and it must be elegant also.
Wow.
And for me, they are like a fashion victim. fashion victim of the 18th century.
Please tell me about this costume.
This costume is a new costume special for the Met. It was one of the, I don't remember, 20 or 25 costume of the chorist. And they must be also fantastic, ridiculous, and the chicken dress.
The chicken dress, it's called. Oh, my goodness.
It's very funny, but at the same time, it's elegant.
It's very
like,
chic.
Like fashion today.
And what's behind you?
It's the dress of the dream. It's very difficult to invent a new dress for Cendrillon. You know, everybody knows Cendrillon. And when I draw this dress, I think first to the color of the black of the ash, mm-hmm. and at the same time the color of the skin. And she's, well, it's like I wanted something very pure, very simple.
It is an absolute dream. Really? Oh, how beautiful. Elisa, yes. This has been a fun show for you, am I right?
It's been a great show. It's come in a great time in the season, and everybody's enjoyed working on these costumes because it pushes them to the next sort of level of traditional costume making to get this to be like a perfect sphere. And more importantly, what you hit on earlier is to actually have the girls be able to walk and sing. And this, the chicken costume and some of the others, I mean, for the choristers was just, you know, so much fun.
You know, it's somewhat unusual for a stage director to also be a costume designer. How did this come to pass?
I don't know. I always did that. For me, it's easier to enter in the head of the character. But it's just, I don't know, a pleasure. I draw a lot. For the movement and for the space in Cendrillon.
Laurent and Elisa, thank you for speaking with me and to the audience.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.